It looks like the private sector actually added some jobs last month. Gay marriage is still live in California, and it looks like the government did store some of those airport scanner photos after all. Hey guys, it's August 4th, 2010. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as Dimcat. The federal government is admitting to storing some of those body scanner photos. Well, it's more than just some. Federal agencies have defended the use of these body scanner technologies, and it turns out the Transportation Security Administration claim that they couldn't actually store these images or record them. Has turned out to be incorrect. It's not true. At this point, the U.S. Marshals Service has admitted this week that they saved tens of thousands of images recorded with the millimeter wave system at security checkpoints at a Florida courthouse. Now, we don't know if this has been happening at the airports, but they've definitely been doing it at this one location right here. They've stored approximately 35,000 images in Orlando, Florida's one of their federal courthouses. Consumer spending and personal incomes both are weak. Big surprise. Consumers did not boost their spending in June, and according to the Commerce Department, factory orders dropped 1.2% in June to a seasonally adjusted $406.4 billion. It was the second consecutive decline after nine straight months of gains. There's been a lower demand for steel, construction machinery, aircraft machinery as well. The National Association of Realtors are saying that the seasonally adjusted index of sales agreements for the previously occupied homes dipped 2.6%. Obviously, things are cooling off. That's actually a surprise, because in the summer you would think that things would be a little bit better. They would actually have more deals going, but obviously not. Okay, a report, only one quarter of the oil is left in the Gulf of Mexico. According to a new government report, three-fourths of the oil in the Gulf of Mexico has been removed. That is more than 152 million gallons. They said this is how much oil has been collected. This is how much has been burnt out. How much has been chemically dispersing, just relocates it, actually. But anyway, naturally deteriorated, evaporated, dissolved. This is actually good news if it's actually true. The problem is coming from the government, and we know that the government and BP have been working together, and they haven't been entirely honest with us from the get-go. So, I mean, it's an issue of credibility right there. Okay, a gunman, Omar Thornton, went on a rampage, and the guy just snapped. He was confronted by a union representative and some supervisors about him stealing beer from a distributor that he worked for. He was basically busted. He didn't really argue. He just quietly signed his letter of resignation. And they said he headed towards the door. He pulled out a gun and he just started to fire. One survivor described it as cold as ice. This guy was 34 years old. He claims that he was suffering from racial discrimination and racial harassment at his workplace. And the mother of his longtime girlfriend basically said that everybody's got a breaking point. It looks like this guy just snapped. We don't know if the guy was telling the truth or not, but I mean, why would he lie if he's going to snap like that? He called his mom on the phone before he was killed. He said, I killed the five racists that were there bothering me. Then he killed himself. People are reaching their breaking point. Okay, private sector adds 42,000 jobs in July. The layoffs actually slowed. So according to ADP, there was actually jobs added in the private sector. So that's always good news. Whenever you see jobs added in the actual private sector. According to the global consulting firm Challenger Gray, and Christmas. What an interesting name. Christmas. Okay. Planned layoffs rose 6% in July to 41,676. So the planned layoffs rose 6%. Downsizing activity stayed at its lowest level since the beginning of the actual recession. Before the beginning of the 2001 recession, I should say. So, sort of good news. Gay marriage. A judge overturns gay marriage ban in California. The judge said that basically it was violating gays' constitutional right in America. And I, for one, believe that gay people do have the right to get married, adopt kids. They should have all the rights that I have, because if they have to pay taxes like everybody else, then they should have the same rights that everybody else has. For me, it's an issue of taxation without representation. I mean, it doesn't seem fair to tax people the same amount as in other groups, but then say this group can't have what the other groups have. So, you guys tell me what you think about that and other issues. Question of the day, should gay marriage be banned and why? Guys, thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. And remember, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.